Then we will move to the emission norms for BS6. We have seen up to BS4. Now we see the BS6 emission norms. Carbon monoxide same 1.5 to 1.5, and hydrocarbon 0.46 to 0.13. It brought down, and particulate matter from 0.02 to 0.01. As I told you, hydrocarbon is controlled by 72%, 0.46 to 0.13. 72% it is reduced, and particulate matter 0.02 to 0.01, 50% it is reduced, and NOx highest it is reduced, 3.5 to 0.4 gram per kilowatt hour. That means 90%, 88.5, when you round it, 90%. 3.5 to 0.4, 90% reduction of NOx, 50% reduction of PM, 72% of HSE. So in a span of 3 years, as I said, BS1 implemented all India in 2000, BS2 in 2005, in 5 years, from BS1 to BS5, 5 year span. Then BS3, BS2 to BS3 again, 5 years. From BS3 to BS4, it is 7 years, 10 to 17, 7 years is took. But whereas BS4 to BS6, and skipping your BS5 in between. So in a short time, 3 years, which is a major challenge for every automobile manufacturer, even though we have overcome that challenge and we met the BS6 norms in a 3 years period. So this is again the slide which is showing you the NOx from 5 to 3.5, BS3 to BS4, again 3.5 to BS4 to BS5, 0.4. And same way, PM 0.10 to 0.02, again 0.02 to 0.01. So here, four pollutants we are discussing, BS4 to BS6, 3.5 to 0.4, 90%. Then hydrocarbon 0.46 to 0.13, that is 70% reduction. Again, carbon monoxide 1.5 to same 1.5. So particulate matter 50% we have reduced. So highest reduction is NOx, that is 90%, which is a major challenge. And for it, what we did, we will discuss. Now we compare BS4 and BS6. In BS4, we use IEGR. That means this is the exhaust manifold, red color. The exhaust gases comes to here, and here there is a wall, EGR wall. And when it is open, the exhaust gas will cooled in this cooler. Then after cooling, it goes to the intake manifold, which is the blue one, intake manifold to the engine. So these green pipes are cooling pipes. The coolant from engine, it will come to here, and it cools in opposite direction, and the hot coolant will go to the, again to thermostat radiator. So here the red pipe is exhaust pipe. The blue pipe is intake pipe, the cooled air. This is the hot exhaust air. This is the cooled exhaust air. Okay. The green pipes are coolant pipes for cooling this hot gas. So by this action, the temperature of the air we are reducing. Second, the oxygen presence is also less quantity, so that the peak combustion temperature will come down. By this way, we controlled NOx, because that time it is, the challenge is 3.5, from BS3 fire to BS4 3.5 to bring. But here it is a big challenge, 3.5 to again 0.4. So to reach that, the EGR only will not sufficient in cylinder. So we have chosen after treatment, exhaust after treatment. So this is important. So in short, we call it as EATS, EATS, exhaust E, after A, treatment T, system S, EATS, EATS, exhaust after treatment system. We will discuss this in detail, which is used in BS6 to bring down the NOx level to 90%, the PM level to 50%, and the CO and HSE we brought to the BS6 norms. And how we have achieved it, we will see in subsequent slides. So in this EATS, there are four important filters are there. You can say the catalyst inside. So one is a DOC. The full form is a diesel oxidation catalyst. Second is a DPF, diesel particulate filter. I will discuss in coming slides. Then you can see full detail about it. Then SCR, selective catalytic reduction. Then ASC, ammonia slip catalyst. These four are put in cylinder in exhaust. These four is commonly called as EATS: DOC, DPF, SCR, ASC. This is the flow, and these four combined is known as EATS, exhaust after treatment system. And supported with here, there is HSE doser. Here is a AdBlue doser, and other things we will discuss, right? So we already discuss this slide, emission control, how it is generated, NOx and CO and HSE and PM, and how to control in cylinder we have discussed. And it is up to BS4, okay, but in BS6 we introduce after exhaust system, after exhaust control system, okay, exhaust after control system. So in that, so DOC is used for controlling carbon monoxide and hydrocarbon. DPF is used particular to control the particulate matter. Finally, the SCR is used to control the NOx. This we will discuss in coming slides. In addition to this, EGR, NOx, we are using already SCR here. In BS6, we are using both. BS4 also, in buses, we use EGR and SCR. But later on, in BS4, we developed our technology by EGR to IEGR, and which takes care complete control of NOx without SCR. There we have done this in BS4, but in BS6 it is necessary to use both EGR and SCR. Without EGR also, SCR will help in control NOx, but again it is burden to the customer. It increases the cost. That I will discuss later. That's what we use both EGR and SCR. It is called a mid NOx technology. Right, we will discuss in coming slides. Here, before going to the EATS components and working principle in detail, now the time is 3:40. Okay, we have another 20 minutes time. Okay, we will complete this EATS components working and principle today. Then in 15 minutes, then we will take some questions for today. Then we will wind up today. Okay. So EATS, as I told you, exhaust after treatment system. Okay. The schematic layout is like this. This is our engine. Okay, after engine, it starts with the DOC, then DPF, then SCR, then ASC. This, if you want to note down, you may note down in your book. In EATS, we have this arrangement. Okay. So here, some temperatures are shown about 200 degree like this. Okay, so this we will discuss in coming slides, right? One item we will come to know here. The other things also I will clear you. This is NOx sensor. I think you all gone through the EDC, ECU sensors and actuators. So in this section I am not discussing about it because it is covered already in BS4. Okay, so we know simple the sensor is the thing which converts the physical variance into electronic signal and gives to the ECU. ECU is a like processor electronic control unit and which receives the signals from sensor and gives command to the actuator. Actuator is the device which receives the signals from ECU in electronic and it converts into the mechanical some physical work. Okay, so sensor, actuator and ECU we know. So here simply I am telling you the NOx sensor, here the exhaust whichever coming out from engine, it measures NOx and gives signal to the ECU, right? Then HESI doser unit. HESI doser, HESI we know it is the nothing but diesel fuel. So whenever it is required, it injects some quantity of fuel here to keep the temperature in this heat system. Mostly the SCR, the temperature is required. When SCR temperature is not maintained, then it triggers to HESI doser through ECU. Then it will inject some small quantity of fuel, so which further oxidize in DOC and the temperature will increase because of that combustion in these filters. So then SCR will achieve that temperature because this everything DOC also need temperature more than 200 degree to do the oxidation process here. Okay, to control the hydrocarbon and CO. Like this, the HESI doser will help whenever it is required. So almost the exhaust gas is sufficient to keep the temperature in these heats. But whenever the amount of temperature is less, when you are traveling in a city or initially you started, the temperature is not sufficient, that time if it is required, then HESI doser will help. Then the T1, it is the temperature sensor. The exhaust gas enters into the DOC, the temperature it measures. Then the exhaust gas coming out from DOC, it is measured by T2 sensor, temperature 2. Then here DPF, there are two pressure sensors which measures the pressure inside the exhaust gas entering into the DPF filter, and the pressure P2 measures the pressure of exhaust gas coming out of the DPF filter. The difference of pressure P1 and P2, it is called delta pressure. So this is called delta pressure sensor. This triggers your regeneration process actually. So that I will tell you in later. So how it delta pressure helps. Then the temperature of the exhaust gas which is coming out of DPF filter is measured by that temperature 3, T3 sensor. And here the length is more from DPF to SCR. I will show you later the construction. It is in bend S type. In one box, DOC and DPF are accommodated. Then there is a bend pipe. In other box, these two are accommodated, SCR and ASC. So because of the length here, so one more sensor is put to measure the temperature of the exhaust gas which is entering into the SCR. And finally, T5 measures the temperature of exhaust gas which is coming out of the ASC. ASC means ammonia slip catalyst. This is the T5. And here T3, T4 in between, there is one AdBlue dozer. This also we will discuss, AdBlue dozer, and which spray injects AdBlue, which is required in SCR for converting NOx into the nitrogen. And here finally there is N2 sensor, which measures the NOx level coming out from exhaust tailpipe. Okay, right. Here construction and all we will see. First of all, when exhaust gas coming out, okay, then we know apart from carbon dioxide and superheated steam, there are four pollutants are there, major pollutants. Number one, hydrocarbon. Number two, carbon monoxide. First of all, these two are controlled in DOC. DOC, diesel oxidation catalyst, and these all four are in honeycomb shape. First, we discuss about DOC, diesel oxidation catalyst. It is having a flow through filter. Whatever exhaust gas comes into DOC, it passes through that honeycomb structure freely out and enters to the DPF. In this entering and coming out, in this process, because of there is a temperature 200 degrees maintained, degree centigrade. So in this honeycomb shape, the filter, what I told you, it is a wire mesh in honeycomb shape, and it is coated with the platinum and palladium, noble metals. And when there is a temperature about 200 degree, these metals will give oxygen, supply oxygen. That is called adding oxygen, oxidation process. By adding oxygen to hydrocarbon, it converts into H2O, and adding oxygen to CO, it converts into CO2. So in that manner, DOC controls hydrocarbon and carbon monoxide both to 95%, up to 95%. Okay, the remaining to some extent, it is controlled again DPF. Again, DPF also having the similar kind of mesh filter, wire mesh filter, and it is also coated with both platinum and palladium material. But DOC is a flow through filter, but DPF is not flow through filter. Here, alternate cells are blocked. So once enters, and it need to come out from the other cell. So here it traps the soot particles. The gases will pass away from DPF filter, but this DPF filter traps the soot, the carbon deposits. So the carbon deposits comes into the DPF filter, it will not come out. So here it controls the soot to 99%. So DPF, CDPF means a catalyst DPF. There is a catalyst which is coated with platinum palladium, I told you, catalyst diesel particulate filter, which traps your soot. And because it is also catalyst, again, whatever the left out hydrocarbon and carbon monoxide, again, it is oxidation process, it will happen. So these will convert into again H2O and carbon dioxide. So these three pollutants are emissions are controlled here, SC, CO and SOOT. After DPF, so here what is available? Only NOx available, then CO2, then superheated steam. So the NOx will be controlled here in SCR. So it is also wire mesh in honeycomb shape, but it is coated with copper geolite. Okay, copper geolite material. So here oxidation will happen in DOC and DPF, but in SCR, because of this copper geolite material, here it is a reductant material. Reductant means it removes oxygen from the available substance. So here what will happen, from NOx it removes oxygen, so it will become nitrogen separate and oxygen separate. So the SCR is a reduction process. That's what selective catalytic reduction, we called it here. Adding oxygen is oxidation, as I told you in the beginning, and the removing oxygen is the reduction, right? After SCR, there is ASC, ammonia slip catalyst, because when it converts NOx to nitrogen, here the AdBlue will help. AdBlue is ammonia, urea solution, which converts here into ammonia. That ammonia will help in converting the NOx into nitrogen, but somewhat the left out ammonia need to be controlled, because as per the emission norms, ammonia should not be more than 10 ppm from tailpipe. So to that ammonia also controlled here in a slip catalyst, ammonia slip catalyst. It is also a honeycomb structure, wire mesh, and coated with copper geolite and platinum. So what will happen? Again, from ammonia, it separates the oxygen and water. So finally here, whatever comes from exhaust tailpipe is, one is CO2, so second is a superheated steam, the third is nitrogen. So this way we control the emission completely. So overall picture you got it. So but these components one by one we will discuss here in this slide. So